Hi children, this is for class 7th, subject is science. Okay, so we are discussing about the topic, that is acid bases and salts. Yes, in last video we are discussing about this topic and we know more about acids, bases and salts. Okay, so let us continue this lesson. Children, you know that the substances which we see, which we are seeing, know that we have classified into acids, bases and salts. How based on their, that is, taste. Yes, so what are acids is here? Acids are substances that taste sour and are corrosive in nature. Okay, corrosive means, as you know that acids, when you touch acids, it burns. Yes, so that is the nature of corrosive. Okay, so when we test this acid with the litmus paper, that it turns, that is, blue litmus paper to red litmus paper. Yes, so when we test any acids, means with the help of this litmus paper, what will happen? When we dip a litmus paper in acid solution, it will convert blue color to red color. We use blue color litmus paper to test acids. Yes, so here these substances are chemically acidic in nature. These are the substances which are sour to taste are chemically in acidic nature. Examples for these, what? Orange juices. Yes, so orange juice, curd, vinegar, hydrochloric acid. So these are all the examples of what? Acids. Yes, so here orange is what? Natural acids. Okay, here that is chemically, that is, which is prepared in the laboratory. Okay, so these are the acids which are sour to taste, and when we tested this acid with the help of, that is, litmus paper, it turns blue litmus paper to red litmus paper, that is, it converts blue to red. Okay, next is what? Bases. Bases are substances that in aqueous solution and which are slippery in nature. One of the property that we have say that bases are slippery in nature and to touch, and which are in bitter to taste. Okay, as you can see that the soaps that we use to wash our body, that we use to clean our body, that is how it is, what is the nature of this? That is slippery nature. Okay, so basically bases are which taste? These are bitter taste and these are slippery to touch or soapy to touch. Okay, and it turns, that is, when we test bases solution with the help of litmus paper, no, it turns red to blue. Okay, we use red litmus paper to test bases, whereas we use blue litmus paper to test acids. And these substances are chemically in basic nature. Okay, those which are slippery to taste, slippery to touch or soapy to touch, and these are in bitter to taste. Okay, so such a property that we are, such a property of our substances are chemically basic in nature. Example for this, what? Soap. Okay, soap that we used, and that we, and ammonium hydroxide. Okay, and also calcium hydroxide. These ammonium hydroxides and calcium hydroxides are used in the laboratory. Okay, that is chemistry laboratory that we use these chemical substances. Okay, and soap is naturally that we are using to wash our body, clean our body. Yes, detergent, soaps. So these are the some examples of what? Bases. Okay, next is what? Neutralization. So those which are sour to taste, those which are bitter to taste, other than these tastes, what we called, that is, when we mixed acid and bases, what we get, that is salt. Okay, so when an acid and base react with each other to form salts, when acids and plus bases get react with each other, what will form? That form that is acid, that is salts. So these are different from acids and bases, and this salt is neutral solution. Okay, why we called neutral solution? When neutral solution, because when we test these salt with a litmus paper, it does not change its color. For example, see, we use blue litmus paper to test the acids. Okay, when it dipped in the acid solution, the blue converts to the red. In that case, when we dip that blue litmus paper in the salt, means it does not change any color. Okay, so for that purpose, this salt is the neutral solution. Okay, so the quantity of acid and base in this salt, that is it in the form of equal amount. Yes, and in this reaction, the acidic and basic nature of the acid and base respectively are destroyed. We could not see this acid, that is the nature of the substance, that is acidic basic, does not see in this salt. Okay, and it is what we called, that is neutral solution. So here, what is mean by neutralization reaction? When an acid and base react with each other to form salt, the producing of a salt by the reaction with acid and base, which we are called neutralization reaction. Okay, and water and heat, then such reaction is known as what? Along with salt, what other substance released from this reaction? That is water and heat. So then such reaction is known as what? Neutralization reaction. Got it? So the reaction, for example, one of the example that we are giving here to the neutralization reaction, that is the reaction between hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide is a classic neutralization reaction, where sodium chloride is formed, that is what here? Salt. Okay, see, hydrochloric acid is the acid in nature, whereas sodium hydroxide is the base. Okay, so here, when this acid and base get react with each other, what will produce? That is salt. Salt, the chemical name of salt is here what? Sodium chloride. What is the chemical name of salt? That is sodium chloride. How this sodium chloride form? By the reaction with hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. Here, what is HCl? That is, what is hydrochloric acid? It is a acid. Whereas sodium hydroxide, NaOH, here Na means what? Sodium, OH means hydroxide. Sodium and hydroxide, that is sodium hydroxide is a base solution. Whereas hydrochloric acid here, acid solution. When these two get react with each other, what will form? Sodium chloride. What is this sodium chloride? This is the chemical name of salt. Along with this, what other will produce? That is water. Okay. So this is the example of what? Neutralization reaction. Next, what? Salts. Salt is the product. It is a product formed from the neutralization reaction. Okay, so in that neutralization, what is the product produced? That is, what is the product formed? Salt is formed. So therefore, it is the product formed from the neutralization reaction of acids and base. So in the reaction between hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide, the salt formed is sodium chloride. Therefore, salt can be acidic, basic, or neutrally, that is neutral in nature. Got it? Okay, next is that what? Indicators. What do you mean by indicators? So as I already studied about this in our last video, okay? See, once again we recall that indicators. Indicators are those substances which are used to test whether the substance is acidic or basic or neutral. Okay, so such substances which we are called what? Indicators. Okay, so by the action of only taste, we could not find that it is a acid base. Okay, so some of the substances are there which can be harmful for us. For that purpose, we couldn't test the substance only by the taste. Okay, so other than these, we can also use other activities by that we can test the given substance is acidic or basic. Okay, so those substances which we are used to test the substance is acidic or basic, that we are called what? Indicators. So these indicators are used to test the acid solution or base solution or the neutral. So here some of the examples are given of indicators, that is we use litmus paper or solution. Okay, so this solution that we get from the plant, that is lichen. Which plant? That is lichen. Okay, so this litmus paper that is available at either paper or in a solution. Okay, so these we get from the papers also or from the that is in the form of solution, that is in a liquid state. Okay, and another one we can use, that is what? Turmeric. Okay, and another one is what? China rose. China rose is one of the indicator that we use to test the acid base and solution. Okay, another one is what? That is phenolphthalein. It is available in the lab. Okay, it is available in the laboratory. It is used to test or it is used to find out the solution acidic or the basic. Okay, see here the neutral indicators. What are these neutral indicators? Natural indicators. These natural indicators are those that we get from the plant or from plant parts. So natural indicators are those which are get from the plants or plant parts which contain some useful chemicals that are used for testing an acidic or basic properly of a solution, or termed as what? Natural indicators. For example, that is China rose. So this another, that is the example for natural indicators, that are what? China rose and turmeric, that is yellow. Is there no? That is also used to test the solution is acidic or basic, are some examples of natural indicators. Okay, natural indicators means what? These indicators that we get from the plant are plant parts which contain some chemicals that are used for testing acidic or basic property of a solution. So litmus is a naturally occurring purple indicator which is extracted from the lichens. Okay, so these are the naturally occurring purple indicators and which is extracted from the lichen. Okay, lichen is a type of a plant where that we get this litmus. So when added to an acidic solution, it turns red, and when added to basic solution, it turns blue. Okay, so when we use this, by using this litmus paper, we can test the acidic and basic solution. Okay, here the litmus paper are of two types, that is the color of litmus paper that is available, that is one is red, another one is blue. Okay, so we use blue litmus paper to test the acidic solution, whereas red litmus paper to test the, that is basic solution. Here what will happen? Blue litmus paper convert to the red when we dip into the, that is acids, whereas red litmus paper, when we dip this red litmus paper into the base solution, it will convert, that is, which color? Red to blue. Okay, so this is what litmus, that is used for to test the acidic or basic solution, and it is available in the form of a solution or as a strips of a paper, that is known as litmus paper. Okay, so here is that the table given that how it converts, that is, so in acidic solution the red litmus no change, whereas in base solution which turns blue color, whereas in acidic solution blue litmus paper turns red, whereas in base solution no change. Next is what phenolphthalein is one of the indicator, is an acid base indicator which is colorless in acid and solution but turns pink to red as the solution becomes alkaline. Yes, so what happens, the phenolphthalein is a, that is, colorless solution, it is a colorless solution. When we add this solution, when we used a phenolphthalein in a drop wise, okay, so when we add this 2 or 3 drops in acid solution, what will happen, it does not change any color, it will become colorless. Okay, whereas when this phenolphthalein indicator drops, when we add to base solution, what will happen, it will becomes pink color, it converts pink color. Okay, so phenolphthalein is an acid base indicator which is colorless in acids. So remember, carefully listen here. So this phenolphthalein is a colorless solution. Okay, when you add this in acids, means what will it will become, it remains colorless solution but turns pink to red as in the solution becomes alkaline. Here alkaline means what? Base. It is a base. Alkaline means base solution. So why we separated this alkaline, why we called these as alkaline, because so bases are there, no, in these bases some of the base solution can be dissolved in water but some base solution cannot be dissolved in water. Those base substances which dissolved in water, that substance which we called what? Alkaline. Okay, so some bases can dissolve in water, that dissolved substance of base substances which we are called what? Alkaline. Okay, so this is converts, that is pink. Okay, so it is a synthetic indicator and is used for the neutralization experiment. So it is a synthetic indicator which is used for neutralization solution. To make the solution neutral, we can use this phenolphthalein indicator. Okay, where in the laboratory? Clear? See, neutralization in daily life. Okay, how this neutralization process applicable in our daily life? Okay, so children, you know that during the indigestion, taking milk of magnesia, that gives us relief as a neutralizes. Do you know, children, sometimes we get some stomachache. Why? Because in our stomach some acid releases, that we are called what? Hydrochloric acid. Okay, so suppose this hydrochloric acid release in our stomach, it increases the amount of hydrochloric acid increases in our stomach, means what will happen, it becomes pain to our body, our stomach. In that condition, what will happen, we use what we drink in such condition, when we are suffering from stomachache, means our mother will give she will give soda. Yes, so in that soda what is present, that is lemon. Okay, and salt. Okay, so this lemon and salt is a neutral solution. It is a neutral solution. When we drink that neutral solution, becomes what will? It will become the neutralization. It will react with that acid and convert the salt. So that salt makes our body relief. Clear? So that is why whenever we feel stomach ache, means it will to neutralize that acid that we drink. What we drink? That is base solution. What is base is here? So that is the soda that we use, no? That is the base solution that we use to neutralize in our body. Okay? So gives us relief as it neutralizes the effect of excess acid. Here, excess acid means what? The hydrochloric acid which is released in our body, no? It will become increases. Suppose the releasing of hydrochloric acid increases our body. In that condition, what will happen? We use this base solution, that is what? Milk of magnesia. Or also we use, that is soda. Yes? Or lemon juice. Clear? So this is how that the process of neutralization that applicable in our daily life. Okay? The effect of ant sting, which is caused by formic acid, can be neutralized by rubbing moist baking soda. Okay? So whenever that is ant sting to, okay, your body, means what will happen on that place when you rub the baking soda, what will happen? It will control the pain of the ant which is injected in our body, the acid solution. Okay, when ant bites our body, means what will happen? It releases formic acid. The acid which is present in the ant, that is what? Formic acid. Okay, in ant, which acid is present? Formic acid is present. Okay, due to this reason, whenever the ants bite to our body, what will happen? We feel burning feel. We feel the burn. Yes. So that burning feel, why? Because in that ant, the formic acid is present. Okay. So when it bites, no, it releases formic acid, and for that purpose we feel burn. In that situation, when we apply on that place, that is the baking soda that we used in our cooking, when you rub on that place, means what will happen? It will become neutralized. Okay. So the formic acid is an acid. When this acid get react with base, what is base is here? That is baking soda. Baking soda is a base. Okay, acid and base mixed together or react together, what will form? That is salt. Salt is here what? It is a neutral solution. In that case, what will happen? It will control the, it to destroy the acid or base solution in that substances. Okay. So this is one of the applicable form that we can see in our daily life. Okay. To ensure that some of the plants can grow well. Okay. Why? Because the soil is treated with either acids or bases, depending if it's basic or acidic nature. Okay. Even though in soil also we can see some of the increasing of our acid solution. In that case, we use some of what, that is fertilizers that we used. Okay, so the by that what will happen? It will convert and neutralize, it takes place neutralization. Okay, even in the fertilization we can see. Okay, so in that what will happen? Suppose in the soil increases this acid, means what will happen? The bases which are used to fertilize, that is the fertilizers that we used to, okay, by spraying the chemicals, what are those chemicals that contains the base solution? Okay, so when in the soil the increases the acid content, means by applying that chemicals, what will happen? It becomes a neutralized and release salts. That is salt what? That makes the soil, that is it increases the its fertilizing nature. Okay, so that ensure plants can grow well, and also the soil is also treated with either acids or bases, depending if it's basic or acidic nature. Okay, so some soil having that basic nature, means by adding acidic it becomes neutralized, whereas the soil which is having a more amount of acidity, that by adding base solution we can neutralize the soil. In that, if the soil become neutralized, that becomes more fertilized. By this we can grow, it can ensure that the plants can grow well. Okay, so it is one of the applicate. So here in this diagram we can also, even in the industries, by really in the industries also used chemicals, that is this neutral, it is also applicable in this neutralization process. Okay, so here some of the examples that I have given, how this neutralization to be applicable in our daily life. Okay, so this is your lesson, that is acid, base and salts. Okay, so in this we learned that what is the properties of acids, bases and salts, and this, how these acids, salts and bases are applicable in our daily life. Okay, so these are the acids and bases, and salts are the chemical substances which are present in the that is substances which we are used in our daily life, or also we used these acid base salts in the laboratory. Okay, so this is about the lesson, that is acid base and salts. Okay, so if you have any doubts, you can ask questions. Okay, so you can text the messages to me. Thank you.